go, monsieur.
Oh, you are serving me a drink this time.
I'm the drink maker today.
I'm starting to like this thing.
Yeah, because you're cooking, so, you know.
We've got the fancy glasses.
I know, and they're small.
Although, some people say we should drink more during the show because the show is much more entertaining at that point. What? Welcome to Chris and Edmi's Kitchen, and this is called a Basil Vodka infused. Gimlet.
And it's really, really refreshing. We put the basil leaves on the vodka and we let them infuse almost the whole day. I mean, it keeps you, but it tastes really good.
I have a feeling these glasses are going to be too small.
We have more.
But for those of you who have little gardens, herb gardens, like we have, the basil's kind of going crazy right now, especially after the rain we had. So this is another way you can actually use it. Infuse your gin. The gimlet really should have been with gin, but we've seen it as vodka. We don't have gin.
We do whatever we have.
It goes down very nice though.
Yeah.
Really nice summer.
And I'm not a vodka drinker. Like, I drink wine and mezcal. This is different.
We've noticed. Yes. Okay. So today's dish.
It's going to be so fast.
Yes.
Don't blink because you'll miss it.
You will miss the show. It's almost like that. But speaking of having more of something, we have extra basil, so we figured, how do we use that?
We gotta use it.
We used the shrimp in the last episode in our asopao, but we had shrimp left over. So now we're going to do another shrimp dish called scampi. This is basically a garlic butter shrimp scampi, just medium-sized shrimp that we're using today. Gonna start it with basically 3/4 of a pound to a pound, up to you how much you wanna eat. Typically it would be put over linguine, over pasta. Today we're going a little healthier. But so we've got fresh parsley, we've got lots of garlic. For me with this dish, the more garlic, the merrier. You should try to crush it up a little bit better. Our crusher was in the dishwasher, so I had to dice it. But very quickly, what we'll do, can I have some heat, ma'am? Other than the usual heat you provide? Okay, so I'm gonna drizzle a little bit of olive oil in here.
Yeah.
Not a lot of olive oil because I'm going to also put a little bit of butter. I like to go with that.
Oh, that's why you want to save the pasta for another dish.
Well, this is not a low-cal dish by any stretch. This is a particular brand, you know, Livio, but there I kind of discovered these butter olive oil combination.
And they're good.
And they're really good.
They have a lot of taste.
And it's a wee bit healthier. So we do that. We toss in the garlic. This is a very basic Italian dish. I mean, there's nothing.
It's done really fast.
It does get done fast. So, again, if you've been watching and playing along, let us know if you've tried any of the recipes because it's kind of fun to see who's done it and who hasn't. If they're happy with how it came out, if they did something a little bit different. Oh, thank you. What surface around here? It's amazing.
I know. The sous chef is fantastic.
Super, 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 super.
The best part of this kitchen, I would say.
So, the one thing, and very humble once again, but the one thing about shrimp. They cook fast. You don't want to overcook them because then you're chewing on a piece of rubber. So in go the shrimp.
My hands are available. Do something.
You're going to be like, I'm going to be the doctor and calling for the ingredients.
Yes.
So that's the pepper, fresh pepper,
salt. Oh, here.
So these are already starting to turn color. And when they do that, you really want to start turning them over because it means they mean business already. They're going. They're doing their thing.
They're going.
I would like some of the fresh parsley.
Fresh parsley. In it goes.
Gonna squeeze some lemon juice in there. Ooh. Probably a 1/4 cup or so.
That's fine. This is less.
I don't know about that.
Mine is less.
You've been drinking.
I've been drinking.
I've been cooking. Boy. At the end of the show, we'll have the recipe for it. It's a simple one, really.
It's very easy.
But really good. And here towards the tail end, we add a little more butter, a lot more butter. Depending upon how you like this. You know what I need?
What?
My red pepper flakes.
Oh my God, my Lord. Does this really have red pepper flakes?
White wine. Don't forget white wine. Any kind of white wine for the most part.
I'm just saying, shut up. Don't complain about the red pepper flakes.
Put a little bit of white wine.
I do.
Got a 1/4 cup. Whatever you want to do to taste. You can always do that after. You don't have to do it, you know, you're sharing this with people, so you don't really.
Looks beautiful. It smells even better.
That's about it. I mean, once they turn that color, you have to be very careful.
I'm curious about when.
And that's the final ingredient. So what you can also do, don't have to do this, and some people put their scampi in the oven and cook it that way. But I like to just at the end I toast some Italian seasoned breadcrumbs, and then at the end just sprinkle it on the top. It adds a little more texture, it gives a little crunch.
So that you add them into this skillet or when you serve it?
When you plate it. This is a heavy.
It looks really good.
This is, imagine that.
I am hungry.
And we're done. And so
we are?
We'll be at the table in a second.
Oh my
Told
God.
You this was gonna be fast, kids.
Should we go off?
Ta-da! Oh, you want to go outside?
Yeah, it's a good day to be outside. I'll just say.
We'll see when we get there. Wish us luck. See you in a couple minutes.
Look what he brought to the table again.
Just in case. Maybe I didn't put enough in. We'll see. Hey, put you some extra breadcrumbs too.
Let's see. It's really good.
Great flavor. Let's see if this drink works. With shrimp scampi.
Olive works.
That's the next little summertime gathering you have. A
very
nice, refreshing, simple, not a lot of ingredients.
Yep.
That recipe's coming up right after this, so we will say, as we stuff our face, Buen Provecho.
Buen Provecho.
Stay well.
See you on the next.
Absolutely. Now, stay for the drink recipe. Yeah. Don't go in it. Don't go.
You'll regret it if you don't try it.
So now it's my turn because you are cooking. It's my turn to do the drink, so we're going to do... what are we doing?
See? I thought you made the drink.
So this is a vodka infused, this is
Oh, we can keep going. Okay. Yeah. Hold up the cue cards.
No, this is a basil vodka infused lemon gimlet.
Next. No. You were close. Hey, I'll be right back.
Take 200. No,
yes,
I'm kidding. But almost. So I'm going to do the drink. I have here some vodka that we infused with basil. We have some lime juice. And we have some simple syrup.
Homemade.
Mm-hmm. We always do our simple syrup. So we're going to throw in the vodka. The lime juice.
A lot of rocks already in there.
And
correct.
The simple syrup.
Okay.
And we're gonna shake it up.
Well, let's see your shaking techniques.
Yeah, I'm afraid. But
make sure the cover's on.
My arms are tight. I gotta move. That's why I'm covering them up. Are you taking the whole rest of me?
Mm-hmm. So, that's it? That's all you gotta shake?
Do I have to shake more?
I don't know. I'm just saying.
I think it gets very cold.
Yes.
So here we got some glass with ice.
Very clean.
Here
looking.
We go. Let's see how it tastes. Of course,
we're gonna garnish it with
basil. Look how cute. Nice looking this is.
And that's how they were made.